Hi all, Profilo is back on YouTube to tell you about our brand new sustainable heating system. This is the Froling T4e wood chip and wood pellet boiler. This is the most technological and innovative wood chip boiler you can find in the market up to now, okay? It is fully automated and completely reliable, and it works with both wood chip that, as you know, we are just producing, you can see some videos on the channel, and also wood pellet, okay? If you're interested in their production, please let me know in a comment. I'm gonna post more videos about them, okay? Before showing you the wall plant, I just want to give you the intuition and some of the reason why we choose this kind of heating system. The first reason is obviously sustainability. The most widespread heating system technologies are fossil fuel based at the moment. You can find natural gas, LPG systems, and also a kerosene or liquid petrol boilers, okay? If you're using one of these, for sure you are impacting negatively on the environment because you are adding CO2 to our delicate atmosphere. And obviously, as you know, CO2 is a gas that is responsible for the global warming, so for sure we do not want to rely on that. Anyway, this video is not about global warming, so let's continue. What does it happen if you use wood chip technologies to warm your house? Well, actually, for sure, you're gonna be a greener person. And second, as you know, plants are carbon-based materials, okay? During their lives, with the photosynthesis reaction, it's a chemical reaction, they take the CO2 from the atmosphere and fix into the wood. Once you're going to burn the wood, actually, you're taking this CO2 from the wood and bringing it back to the atmosphere. So at the end of the cycle, you are perfectly carbon neutral, okay? Another question up to now is, where do we take the material? Where do we take the wood chip? Well, you have to know that I live in the countryside, almost exactly in the wood, okay? So we have a lot of material around here. At the moment, a lot of people are heating their houses with traditional systems like fireplaces and also wood stoves, okay? They have worked well for years, but now I think that there are more reliable and technological systems like this one. Another question is, why exactly wood chip? Well, first of all, this is a way to be sustainable. So this is a way to recycle branches and also woodworking production wastes, any kind of waste. And instead of throwing away everything, the idea is to reuse material. Actually, they do not have value, and the only way to give them value, in fact, is to burn them. Remember that all these, in fact, are very, very low quality material because you have a lot of resin inside, you have a lot of bark, so you cannot use them in traditional systems. In this example, you can use a wood chip coming from big trunks where you do not have a lot of bark compared to the trunk component, okay? In this case, obviously, the system is going to work really better because the heating power of the material of this material is much higher than the one of the branches. But in this case, it is going to cost more, and actually, you're not really using branches. We would like to recycle. Okay, at that point, we can start with the boiler description. The system starts from the wood chip storage room on that side. The storage room is simply made of fireproof bricks, okay, to ensure safety against fire. You can see a big reserve of wood chip that, for the moment, we are loading manually. Underneath the material, you can find out the fuel transport system that is composed of several elements. First of all, you see a big agitator that is moved by gearbox. On it, you have long springs that actually are used to grasp the material and to bring the material into the main feeding screw that brings the wood chip to the boiler. Okay, I just want to let you notice or report a detail about these springs. On their hand tip, there is a metallic element that is actually a shear edge that is used to cut wood chip pieces from the lateral part and to guarantee constant feeding to the system. Let's go back in this region that is the one where there is the boiler, okay? The boiler is composed of two main parts, the combustion chamber and the heating exchanger. Let's start first with the combustion chamber. First element is this component here, that is the stoker. The stoker is a mechanical group that separates the main feeding screw with the combustion chamber on the right, okay? Now, the stoker is composed of few motors and also an internal 200mm cylinder that actually is important for two main reasons. The first one is that it's made of two pins. Actually, in fact, it is called twin chamber rotary valve. During the operations, you can see, I'm gonna open the lid here, you can see the wood chip coming from the main feeding screw, then it falls down into one bin, the valve rotates and the wood chip falls into the secondary screw. There is an important detail about this cylinder. You can see blades on the top of the cylinder. This is necessary because there are cases in which there are long branches, long pieces of wood, and these, they may block the wall system. So these blades are going to cut them in order to let them pass, okay? You also have torque controls here. If the PLC, the logic of the stove, sees too much, for a few cycles, there is too much current absorbed, then it raises an alarm and stops the boiler because it means that there is something cannot be cut, actually. This happened a few days ago with a piece, a long piece of iron that obviously cannot be cut in two or more. A detail about the lid here. You can see a safety switch on it. It is really important because there are cases in which the wood chip is blocked inside the stoker and so the wood chip tries to come out. In this case, the switch position passes from the neutral to the alarm position. It raises actually an alarm and blocks the wall stove. In this case, the operator has to manually remove the additional wood chip and has to unblock everything. Now, the second reason why it is important is that this stoker, this rotary valve inside, is actually implementing what is called a burn back protection. Since the secondary screw is directly connected to the combustion chamber, here you have high temperatures, fumes and flames, and there may be situations in which they go back. They may ignite fire inside the second feeding screw, and then the flame and the high temperature fume may return back to the wood chip storage room. This is obviously not good because you may ignite fire also inside the storage and everything goes away. We do not like that. And so this rotor twin chamber rotary valve, by rotating, is going to cut the air flux, and so it is improving the safety level of the wall system. At that point, I can show you the heart of the system, that is the combustion chamber. I'm gonna show you, let's open the panel. Okay, inside, this is the moment you were waiting for. The combustion chamber is made of a very robust structure of silicon carbide that is specifically designed for high temperatures conditions. And there are holes that are guaranteeing a correct air flux for the combustion. I'm gonna give you a detail about the ignition system. There are two different technologies. One is represented by this, that is actually an industrial air heater. It heats up the air to high temperatures. The air goes directly against the wood chip and then after a few minutes it's gonna ignite fire. Actually, this system is not installed here because I had several feedbacks, and you have the fan that after a lot of cycles is going to break, so they are not really reliable. In this case, they installed a ceramic fire igniter. It heats up, it is in contact with the wood chip, and after a few minutes, obviously, it's going to ignite fire. This is safer, more silent, and it is more economical because it is low power, and so it is better. Now, the fire, once produced on the bottom of the combustion chamber, goes up in a tiny but a small hole inside the chamber. You can see it on the video. And as you see here, there are a lot of ashes. So let's briefly talk about ashes. What are they made of? Well, actually, the combustion reaction produces heat. That is what we want, okay? Together with heat, we have carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and also water, and also solid residuals that are all of these materials that cannot burn. The production of ashes is strongly related to, first of all, the quality of the material. If you have resin, if you have bark or not, how much bark you do have, and is also strictly related to the temperature of combustion. This is a 50 kilowatts of power boiler, so in order to have a good combustion, you have to let the boiler heat up a lot. Ashes are divided into two main categories, bottom ashes and flying ashes. Bottom ashes is the most consistent fraction of produced ashes. They are really, really heavy. They actually remain in the combustion stage, okay? Flying ashes are those lighter. They actually follow the flow of fumes inside the boiler. They go up to the turbulator. You can find them in the flue lines and also on the top eventually. Now, since we do have two types of ashes, this boiler has two separate automatic cleaning system for ashes. One screw, they're both at the bottom of the boiler. One screw is for frying ashes and the other for bottom ashes. First cleaning system is about bottom ashes, and it is a screw underneath the main combustion chamber. Obviously, once they're produced, they just remain in the combustion stage and they fall down. At the bottom of the combustion chamber, there is a plate, an horizontal plate with holes, and ashes are falling down. During the startup procedure, this plate tips few times of 110 degrees so that the accumulated material on it falls completely down into the screw, and then it is collected in a rake. Then the second cleaning system is about flying ashes. In the bottom part you have turbulators. At the startup procedure they are shocked in order to let the flying ashes fall down. Now finally, at the bottom of the boiler you see the ashes box. It is composed of, since you do have two screws going inside, you have also two brakes. It is really easy to open. You just unlock the safety switch, you move the leverage, you detach the box from the two screws. There is a detail about them at the bottom. And then finally you can open it. Please notice a detail about the lid. You have a ceiling because you do not want air leakages. Since this system is not pushing the air inside the chamber, it's just pulling the air, if you have leakage at the bottom, you're gonna have a bit of air passing through the lid, and so you're gonna reduce the efficiency. Now let's continue with analysis. In the backward part of the stove, you have the heat exchanger part. Here you have the cool water that passes through tubes, or through pipes, okay? You have several lines of pipes, and you have those elements called turbulators. This is a representation, obviously. They are like steel screws. They are here because of two reasons. The first one is that they are introducing turbulences. They are just moving the fumes. And so introducing turbulences here, you guarantee always hot air in contact with the tubes. The other reason is that since they are slowing down the speed of the air, flying ashes slowing down, they fall. These are also cleaning the air. The automatic cleaning procedure is something like this. The turbulator goes up, and then it goes down. In this way, you are always ensuring the fact that tubes are completely clean. At that point, you have the fumes going up in the turbulators. They just give their heat to the hot, to the cold water. And then finally, fumes go into the flue lines. The ideal flue lines is a straight vertical line that goes up to the roof. In this case, because of the design of the plant, we had to insert two 90 degrees turns and one horizontal line. We do have one turn here, horizontal straight, another turn, and then we go straight vertically to the up to the roof where there is the chimney. Please notice that at the startup procedure of the boiler you see that the smoke is almost white gray because you still have a bit of combustion residuals in the since the boiler is not fully heated up. But remember that once it is going on for several hours and it is heated up correctly, the smoke is really clear. Now there is a last detail about the boiler. On the back you have an internal blower that is moved by a speed controller EC in the induced motor. As I told you before, this boiler is just pulling the air from the atmosphere actually to the into the combustion chamber through holes. Then there is combustion, there are fumes, and then the blower actually pulls fumes up to the roof through the flue lines. Okay, this motor is speed controller. What does it mean? There is a lambda sensor on the back that actually analyzes all the fumes, and depending on their analysis, the PLC adjusts the velocity of the blower in order to control the quantity of oxygen inside the chamber in order to maximize the efficiency of the combustion. This is a really intelligent system. Finally, I'm gonna show you up here on the top, you'd have the control logic, the PLC and all the drives. And finally, in the front panel, you do have the human-machine interface that you can use to navigate the system. You can see information about temperatures, boiler temperatures, water temperatures, pump position, and you can also specify time slots in order to heat your house or heat the sanitary water. Well, actually, you have several solutions, okay? It is really intuitive. For today, I finished this video because I just wanted to give you a description of the boiler. Maybe another video, if you're interested, let me know in the comments. I'm gonna do a video about the pipe description and the heating, the pumps, the heating description, and also the two water, technical and sanitary water accumulations, okay? Thank you all. Like the video, subscribe, and please remember, let's heat up your house sustainably. Bye.